Ladies and gentlemen, these criminals are going wild. Thankfully, Tony Bobulinski, former business partner and former best friend forever of Hunter Biden, well, he's in front of Congress today testifying, and we're about to get into that and what he said. But first, I want to take a moment to thank the sponsor of today's video, and that is Midas Gold Group. I almost forgot. Midas Gold Group. They're a second generation veteran family-owned gold, silver, and precious metals IRA firm. They protect your money from Bidenomics, and that is Bidenflation. High gas prices, collapse of the dollar, and bank runs. Contact them today at MidasGoldGroup.com. Call them 480-360-3000. Links down below in the description. Mention Vlad from American News Network. They'll take care of you. Let's get right into it. On Tuesday, former Hunter Biden business partner Tony Bobulinski will testify before the House Oversight Committee behind closed doors, aka he already did. Bobulinski has been an outspoken critic of the Biden family for years now. Of course, the media has mostly ignored his accusations against Hunter and Joe Biden. So as you see here on the screen, there are some, you know, this is from today's hearing, a bunch of different IDs that Hunter Biden has used for travel and business all over the world. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me ask you this. How many IDs do you have? Me personally, I got my social security card, you know, but I never take it out. I got my birth certificate. I got my driver's license, right? State issued ID. And I got my United States passport. That's it. Yeah. Now, here, there's a transcript of what Tony Bobulinski said this morning, his opening statement. I read through the whole thing, and I wanna point out the most important things. So I read the entire thing. We're not gonna read the entire thing, but I'm gonna go through the most important stuff. So here's this little part. For nearly 4 years, I have tried to tell the American people the truth about serious corruption at the very top of their government. In return, I have been falsely accused of being a purveyor of quote-unquote Russian disinformation and a political surrogate. My continuous efforts to inform the American people of the facts have been effectively suppressed by both the United States government and the so-called mainstream media. Now, we're going to go down a little bit and we're going to read this page. The only reason any of these international business transactions took place with tens of millions of dollars flowing directly to the Biden family was because Joe Biden was in high office. The Biden family business was Joe Biden, period. Ladies and gentlemen, do not forget, this is Tony Bobulinski's behind closed doors meeting with Congress today. He testified under oath. Further down, he actually finishes off with, "I'm not lying. I know that if I lie, it is perjury, and I can go to federal prison for a long, long time." He actually ends with that, and we're about to get to that. But don't forget, this is Hunter Biden's former best friend forever, testifying not against Hunter, but against Joe, his daddy, saying the only reason we made any money, the only reason Hunter and I are in business is because of Joe Biden. The Biden family business was Joe Biden, period. Other key players have made this point clear as well. Hunter Biden himself has adamantly stated it in various and a variety of communications, as did other Biden family business associates. Devin Archer and his testimony last year, foreign nationals on the other side of these transactions, including from China, Ukraine, and Romania, have also explained how and why these transactions took place. Once again, I would call that extensive evidence. The Chinese Communist Party, through its surrogate, China Energy Company Limited, or CEFC, a CCP-linked Chinese energy conglomerate, successfully sought to infiltrate and compromise Joe Biden and the Obama-Biden White House. This process started in the fourth quarter of 2015 and continued through when Joe Biden left office in January of 2017 to March of 2018, when CEFC Chairman Yi was detained for corruption in China, never to be seen again. And here's some stuff. Joe Biden was aware of the CEFC transaction, enabled it, and had a constitutional responsibility, an obligation to the American people to shut it down before it began. This is because CEFC has been identified as a known surrogate of the Chinese Communist Party by the United States government and prosecutors in the Southern District of New York as far back as 2016, possibly earlier. I would encourage Congress to gather all of the exact facts and dates. It is clear to me that alarm bells should have been going off in the Obama-Biden White House and that Joe Biden should have been aware that his own administration had red flagged CEFC as a tool of the Chinese Communist Party. This should have made any business transaction with CEFC a non-starter. So the Obama-Biden administration red flags CEFC. Biden goes and does business with them. In other words, when he saw that they are crooks, when he saw that they are communist controlled and owned, when he saw that they are globalists and radicals and a corrupt entity, he was like, I love it. My type of people. Let me go and do business with them. Let me go and make some money off them. But the only reason they would ever want to do business with the Vice President of the United States is to pay him a lot of money to get top secret information about the United States. Here comes Crooked Joe with his hands wide open. I got a crackhead son. Can we get some money? He needs hookers and crack. And I'm a crook, says Joe. Have you noticed every company that Joe Biden or Hunter Biden ever worked with, they come out to be criminal government run, like Burisma or from Ukraine or CEFC from China. But before the Biden started working with Burisma, and before the Biden started working with CEFC, everybody knew that they are corrupt companies. So he doesn't go to them before he found out they're corrupt companies. He goes to them after it's discovered that they are corrupt companies. Why? Because a crook always wants to do business with crooks. I personally met with Joe Biden in Los Angeles in May of 2017 multiple times to discuss the broad contours of our business dealings. The only reason Joe Biden met with me privately during the Milken Institute Global Conference and seated me at his head table was because I was a business associate of the Biden family. And we're going to read this last part. The rest you guys can go read on the Gateway Pundit, but this one was also good. Joe Biden's immediate family members were enriched to the tune of tens of millions of dollars from some of our most dangerous adversaries, including the Chinese Communist Party and players from Russia, Ukraine, Romania, Kazakhstan, and other foreign nationals and entities. It is my educated belief, dating back to Q clearance briefings I received in the Navy and continuing through recent discussions with experts, that under United States corruption laws, political office holders can be held as responsible as the immediate family members who are receiving money directly. This makes common sense, and Americans understand this. The facts we are going to discuss today appear to me to present disturbing evidence. Now, why is all this happening now? They're about to get rid of Joe Biden and install somebody else to run from the Democrat Party. We saw the special prosecutor investigation. They said he's mentally unwell. They said he's mentally cuckoo. Doesn't remember anything. He's a elderly citizen man who means well. But his memory is of a chicken. You know why I say chicken? Because chickens can actually count to three. That's it. So let's say a chicken hen has five baby chicks. You can take one away, two away. As long as she has three, she's fine. Leave her with two, right? Three or under. She starts panicking. Because even a chicken can count up to three. Joe Biden, chicken, crook. Same thing. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm starting to see how the Democrat Party is setting up Joe Biden to resign in shame. To resign in shame, and his legacy is not going to be good. But I'm going to keep following this, and I'm going to keep you guys informed. So please make sure to like, comment, subscribe, share this video with a friend or two. Trump 2024 or sooner.